in a bachelor degree and then studied Sciences Po Paris, Diplomas in Political Science at Benedictus Magnus University, my second master degree. And now the PhD International Relations Manager and International Cooperation Department at Azerbaijan State University of Economics, UNED, and also lecturer on Sociology and Political Science and International School of Economics. So basically, I could select any kind of like the topic regarding the European Union, but actually I know that the European country members is really having good background regarding the policy affairs, that's why I did not select this. But actually, I could also select the economic development or the socio-economic integration of immigrants in Azerbaijan or something like that. But I would like to, how can I say, choose the something internationalized topic. That's why today, you know, that the energy diplomacy, especially energy security, is the basic element of the relevant strategy as well as the today's relevant happens in the international arena. That's why the international, pretty international topic and the relevant topic in terms of Azerbaijan, in terms of Turkey, etc., as well as the EU countries, EU member countries. So basically, here is the main outline. We will first move on to the theoretical approach to the energy resources, energy diplomacy, as well as the security issue of Azerbaijan, role of Azerbaijan in European energy policy, as well as some kind of conclusion and the recommendation I will giving out. Then, regarding the theoretical approach, we could say that, as I mentioned, that I don't know, you do have some kind of background regarding the theoretical background or something like that, but would like to mention that regarding the neoclassical realism, the neoclassic member said that if you have the natural resources, it means that you need to provide the national security as well as the foreign policy in a harmonized way. But if you do not have the natural resources, if you are the main consumers of the energy resources, so you also need to, again, provide your domestic security by getting the affordable energy resources in an efficient way. So as mentioned here, that natural resources are the main element of the maintenance of the domestic security and the foreign policy. According to the neoclassical realism or the paradigm, energy resources are the power element. If you have the energy resources, you are the powerful state. For example, you know the famous diplomat Brzezinski, Zbigniew Brzezinski mentioned always that today's geopolitical strategy of the world has already changed. Now the idiom of the international politics is something like that. If you have the energy resources, you run the world. But before it was like this, if you run the Eurasian arena, like the Russian part, you know, that the Central Asia and the South Caucasus, you are the leader of the world. But right now the situation completely changed because we do have some kind of conventional energy resources as well as the renewable energy resources. We have the renewable energy resources in terms of the Norway, we could give the example Iceland. Now I know that the Lithuania is really interested in providing the diversification of energy resources. Dependence of the gas, we do know that the EU has the large dependence of the Russia. So EU also need the diversification of the energy resources by getting through different kind of energy supply country. So we are also going to be ready to be the reliable energy partners for the European countries to lessen the dependence of the EU on Russian gas. So another one, can stay up. Famous energy scholars, as well as we could say that the realist, as you remember, Nicholas Carrel, mentioned that the energy, it's like the instrument. But it's an instrument in a coercive way. Coercive, you mean like what it means? It means that you use some kind of assertive actions to force other countries to comply with some kind of measurements to other countries. So it means that energy resources force other countries or the consumers to do something. So it's in a negative way. So, for example, Russia today uses their energy weapons, not diplomacy, or the non-energy statecraft. Energy weapons, it means that I have a weapon like an energy in my hand. As you know, the Russian has the limitless energy resources, and it's a powerful state in the international arena. We could say the so-called powerful state, but in an assertive way. Use the course of energy diplomacy to to just put action against some state and say that, oh, I have an energy. I can put some kind of sanction to you, and I can even stop the shipment of the energy resources, and then you will suffer from the withholding of the gas resources in your country. So it's energy weapon. We could say that the natural, all the nation states use the energy weapons. No. Turkey is referring to the liberalization of the energy resources. So it's energy instrument. Energy instrument is positive sum strategy. Energy weapons is zero-sum strategy. The winning power is Russia, other power will lose. Because the Russia took some kind of sanction or stop the shipment of the energy resources. But when it comes to the energy statecraft or the instrument, it's so persuasive and also the collaborative approach. It's a little bit referred to the neoliberalism. Liberalization of the free trade, harmonization of the energy markets, and also the some kind of internationalization of the energy market and putting some kind of centralized energy mechanism all of the states. So the, also the energy instrument can, for example, EU put some kind of investment in Azerbaijan. So try to influence in Azerbaijan in a more collaborative way, but not in a certain way compared to the Russia. After the toppling down of the Soviet Union, Russia has opted for the strategy of energy weapon, trying to affecting the post-Soviet countries by using the energy resources as a weapon. But right now, EU tried to make collaboration with other nation states, Turkey, the Georgia, South Caucasus region, as you know, the southern gas corridor we do have right now. Then the other countries, like see the energy supplies, but more collaboratively. Because EU wants to have a reliable energy partner in a secure way. One, the securitization of the energy supplies directly by Italy to the other European countries gradually. Did you get? Okay. Then you have, if you have many questions, you can ask to me. If even would like to have my presentation, in the future, if you would like to do research in an expertise in Azerbaijan, not in Azerbaijan, actually in some kind of background in Azerbaijan, as you know that energy is irrelevant, it's not about only Azerbaijan, it's about having the natural resources country. If you have, you can give my email to you, then I will share all of you while going to drive, don't worry about that. There is also triadic nexus. Triadic nexus, what is that? There is a triangle instrument. It means that energy mainly related to the national security and the foreign policy. If you have energy resources and if you have the true energy legislation over conventional as well as the renewable energy resources, and you are able to provide some kind of clear-cut decision and the measurements to have the flexible implementation of these resources, it means that you have successful domestic policy. That's why you have the legislation, because of your successful domestic policy. Regarding after the implementation of domestic security and domestic policy main related to the foreign policy, then you can apply some measurements towards the foreign policy issue, and then how can I say improve or how can I say get forward or involve your energy policy in a more secure way. Here is the same things like the national power. States must be able to extract them economically, but in a rational way. You have to have many, also the limitless energy resources. But it doesn't mean that you can use them like a waste way. You have to use them in an affordable way, like gradually, like the balance and the harmonization of the conventional energy resources. Just thinking about the future that how these resources can be handled into the other next generation for my future economic and the social development. The state must be able to have the economic resource for developing the extraction, production, refining, and export. Right now, the EU partner countries, Azerbaijan is going to have the Norway and other countries, like the Norwegian and other EU experts, to have the some kind of investments in the extraction, production, refining, and the export of the renewable energy resources. We do have all of the partners with the McKinsey Institute from UK, United Kingdom, Siemens from the Germany, like to have the exploration of the oil and gas resources, but not actually like the alternative energy resources. Then I will explain why.
Then, the role of energy in foreign policy, as I mentioned, is the effective implementation of the energy diplomacy. Energy is a main statecraft and the instrument of achieving the successful energy foreign policy, indicator of the national prosperity, and also underlines the importance and the relevance of the domestic security as well. Energy security. For the EU, there is also two main divisions, security of demand and the security of the supply. What means the security of demand? Non-reliance. For example, non-reliance, moreover, on gas resources. In the EU example, non-dependency, merely on oil and gas resources. As you know, that Turkey right now, the gas communal expensive consumption in Turkey is really high. The people are suffering from giving high expenses, like, you know, the high expenses for the gas. That's why Turkey needs to have the alternative energy resources. Mr. President Erdogan always mentioned that we do have the high dependence on gas resources, but we are not sure about why they have the gas dependence of dependence on gas. You know why? There is a Turkey-Greek, you know, the conflict. If Turkey allowed Greece to have some kind of exploration in Aegean Sea, they can get lots of oil resources as well, because there is a limited area, but it's conflicted. Turkey cannot allow the Greece to exploit this area because it's a little bit part of the Greece and the most part of it goes to the Turkey. But there is some kind of conflicting issue. That's why they cannot exploit or they discover the fields. But there are limitless oil resources. That's why Turkey is limited with only within its territory to have the gas resources. Another gas also coming from as an importer, as an exporter, Azerbaijan also ship. Like deliver the gas resources to the Turkey as well. So security of supply, it's about the sustainability, safe shipment. In the example of the EU, EU also need the non-conflicted shipment or the safe shipment. EU needs some kind of, how can I say, need the non-conflicted areas in order to provide non-stop sustainability and the delivery of the energy resources. Key principle of the energy, it's the, according to Jan Kalich, energy scholar, and the David Goldman, there is a main principle of which is pretty relevant for all the countries, guys. Diversification, we know that, or the diversity of the energy bazaar market. Security margin, they have to be some kind of security, non-stop shipment, non-conflicted area, or some kind of thing. High quality information, you do have the, some kind of true energy legislation, true energy operation mechanism. It's about the high information, high quality information. Stable energy market, we right now the EU has the stable energy market, but in the imminent years, if they do not provide the diversification of the energy resources, they could, how can I say, meet with some kind of challenge regarding the stable energy market. We cannot meet with the problem of the case of the Poland syndrome, you know, that only focusing on the oil resources, then just go down in the economic development. The research development and innovative breakthrough. We do have the research development and innovative breakthrough in oil and gas resources, but we do not have the R&ID phenomenon, like the conception in renewable energy resources. That's why we do have some kind of instrument and RID, you know, the implementation. So energy diplomacy in Azerbaijan, it's like the Caspian Sea. You know that Azerbaijan, in South Caucasus, Azerbaijan is the only country with the rich offshore gas and oil fields. And also providing the gas to Georgia, then Turkey, then Kazakhstan, and other Central Asian countries. As you know that we do have some conflict issue with the Armenia, Nagorno-Karabakh issue. Armenia is out of the energy, getting energy resources from Azerbaijan, and also the closing of the border from the Turkey side, energy gas resources, and also from the Georgia side. We cannot deliver any kind of energy resources.